is you feeling me? If not, you feel my energy. See, I know I'ma make it, but even if I don't feel bad. Cause honestly, all these times that I had, those will be the best memories.
All right, what is up, guys? Welcome back to TGTV. So, we've got a brand new episode here in the Kentucky Knights series. We're going to be starting off with an around the league. I wanted to, first of all, sort our team looking at age, so I can kind of show you guys what I'm planning to do throughout the season. We're starting off, I'll go out and show you. We are 3-8 at the moment. Hopefully that turns around, but I'm trying to decide if I want to make moves to make this team good now or maybe look even towards next season or the season after. We're going to be going about this, I think, a lot more differently. I don't know if that's the right grammar. A lot differently than most custom series where we're not amazing right out the gate. So I really do want to try to build around Wiggins, hopefully around Whiteside. If we do get a great offer for Whiteside, though, I may move him just because also that salary is massive. Anyway, though, this is our team. This is the Kentucky Knights. Moving on, the Los Angeles Lakers, Paul Millsap, Kyle Lowry, and Tony Allen. Not like the most stellar big three, I'll be honest, but they seem like overall pretty average, like pretty well talented. Looking at this Magic team, not impressed at all. They got Kemba and Gordon Hayward, but after that is just kind of a huge downfall. Oh, they do have Zach Randolph too. That's probably what's making their team look not as good. The Mavs look like a team not to mess with. That's a great starting lineup right there. So definitely a team, actually not even their starting lineup, they have two centers. So a talented Mavs team for sure. Something about Draymond Green in a Mavs jersey actually kind of looks right. The Nets have Dame, they got Chris Middleton, Danilo Gallinari, and Marcin Gortat. They got 480 and aboves. That's definitely something to look out for. That team's looking pretty good. Let me look at our team quickly. How many A's do we have? So we have actually three. Really, judging by these other teams, we don't look that much worse so far. This next team, really, this Nuggets team is all James Harden. I'm glad TJ Warren getting the respect he deserves at an 80 overall. I didn't know that. Nikola Jokic, so they get one Magic player back. Pretty decent team right there. They got Isaiah Thomas, Kevin Love, Yusuf Nurkic, and another team that I think Isaiah Thomas at an 86, like, obviously he's a great player, but I wouldn't want him again on this team just because of how difficult he is to play with. But in a computer simulated setting, like, he's obviously unbelievable. Look at that. Look at those. Oh my god. Those stats are insane. That Pacers team might be one not to mess with. Next up, we've got the Pelicans, who look like they're in the same boat as us, really looking to just get better in the future. They got Nerlens, they got Ben Simmons. I think that's a good way to go about things. They also have Jimmy Butler. Wow. Okay, never mind. That team is, like, very good. Like, within the next two seasons, this is probably one of the championship teams in my mind. Make sure to let me know down below, guys, what you guys think, what teams look really good to you. Next up, we've got the Pistons, Al Horford and Blake Griffin on the same team. And then they really do fall off after that, but pretty talented. This Raptors team, basically all Russell Westbrook, gets reunited with Steven Adams. But besides that, man, I'm not too afraid of this team. Actually, I don't know. This is a pretty good team. Russell Westbrook himself just makes that team very good. Can we see, we can't see how this team's record is, I don't think, but I wish you would show that on the screen. This team, not impressed with at all. Another team that I think maybe is going for the young, developing aspect with Kristaps and Emmanuel Mudiay, excuse me. They also got CJ McCollum, so I guess within a few years they could definitely be a good powerhouse team. And wow, the Spurs, okay. This team is good. Oh my god, this team is good. Obviously, LeBron himself just does so much for the team. Then you got Reggie Jackson, aka Bobby Shmurda, running with Greg Monroe, and then two amazing young players right here. That's a team I might want to make a trade with to try to get one of these two. Ideally, I think I might want to go after Buddy Hield because I think I can really develop him well. Looking at the Suns, Giannis, Avery Bradley, Larry Nance, and then Chris Dunn. Decent enough team. Not a team I'm, like, horribly impressed with, though. So nothing too great about that team. Next up, Oklahoma City gets Anthony Davis with Joel Embiid. That is just lethal down low. A lot of you guys want me to get Embiid. I'm going to make an effort to try to get him. Booker and Embiid are the two guys you guys kept saying to get, so I will make my best effort to get them. Kawhi Leonard, Mike Conley, Julius Randle, Jared Sollinger, Wes Matthews, Jan Mahimi. They got a really good squad of guys on that team. Timberwolves definitely one to look out for. Something about Kawhi in a Wolves jersey actually looks kind of right too. Chris Bosh, that's really it. And Marc Gasol, these injuries keep messing me up. A lot of early season, like, big name injuries going on right now. Dwayne Wade and the Warriors, who we will be playing in the next video. I cannot believe that he is an 88. Like, that seems a little high for him, but I don't know. Wizards, Dwight Howard, Derek Favors, Chandler Parsons, Dennis Schroeder, and Jamal Crawford. Jay Crossover is too good. You guys know that. Oh, you can see all players now. That's actually kind of cool. Curry's a 94. I guess we'll see what team Curry's on. Klay Thompson leading the 76ers, and they seem well-rounded. They seem like a team who wants to win right now, judging by the ages, judging by their overalls. So maybe a team to look out for, but I feel like that's also the type of team that after the season, if they don't win now, they might not be winning anytime soon. Next up are the Milwaukee Bucks. John Wall, my boy. Rudy Gay, Zach LaVine. Is that Miles Plumlee? Mason Plumlee, excuse me. And is that Michael Beasley? Wow, I forgot he was still in the NBA. Jeez. Next up, the Bulls. DeMar DeRozan leading their squad with Eric Bledsoe and Brooke Lopez. That's pretty good. That's like a good... I wouldn't even call that a big three, but that's a good, like, solid three to build around. And I think they could use a few more pieces, and they're not quite there, but definitely getting there. The Cavs get Steph Curry. I don't know how Cavs fans feel about losing LeBron and getting Steph Curry, but Steph, Rudy Gobert, Victor Oladipo, I think that's a pretty solid team. That's a team I'd be afraid to play, for sure. Paul George in a Celtics jersey, that looks so nice. Him, Dirk, and Tristan Thompson, I'm not impressed with this team at all. I think after this year, this team is going to be trash. They're really relying on Dirk as their second best player, and then JJ Redick's getting up there too. Although he is mainly a shooter, so he won't really go down that much based on like athleticism and everything. But anyway, on to the Clippers. LaMarcus Aldridge, Jonas Valanciunas, and Tony Parker, with Manu Ginobili taking the two Spurs guys. Another decent team. I'm really not sure who I would call the best teams. Probably the Spurs, I would say, are the best team. And then the Pelicans, I'm afraid of in the future, because they got Simmons and they got Nerlens and they got Jimmy Butler. But we got Boogie, Tobias Harris, and then KCP's the next best. This team is just like, that's nothing to me. This team within a few years is going to be crazy. Are you kidding me? This is the team of the future. Brandon Ingram, D'Angelo Russell, and Karl Anthony Towns. Can you imagine? Jeez, that team is sick. They got to make sure they re-sign all those guys for sure. The Heat got Chris Paul and Harrison Barnes, and yikes, that team is bad. Chris Paul is going to be very upset playing there. I can say that much. Going on to the Hornets, Kyrie Irving leading the squad with Rodney Hood and Danny Green. Another team that I just think is led by one guy, and I don't know if it's the guy that can really lead a team completely on his own. On to the Jazz, Melo, Enes Kanter, and Rajon Rondo with Jabari Parker. I'd say this team could be decent. I think they could play well. I don't know. Probably a little slightly above average team. And I think this is the last team. Two more teams to look at. Andre Drummond, Devin Booker, and Andre Iguodala. Of course, you guys want me to target Booker. I will make sure to target him in the next trade episode. Him and Joel Embiid. I will make sure to try to get on the squad. Looking at the Knicks, Kevin Durant, Pau Gasol, Bradley Beal. I like this team. I think that team can really do well. But anyway, guys, that is the league. Thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you haven't. Tell me where we match up, who's the worst team, and who's the best team down below. And I will catch you guys next episode with a game. Peace.